like her updo hairstyle. I've taken a little inspiration from Amy Winehouse's kind of beehive hairstyle. So obviously she's used to kind of wear a wig or like half her hair and half wig, and then also her hair was long and it was like wavy straight. So what I'm going to show you how you can do something a little bit similar, but something you can wear whenever. So first of all, I had a braid out in my hair, so I just took all the braids out because I think it's easier to work with rather than if I decided to wet my hair and it would be too curly for me to like kind of style it, like when I leave it out. So using my kind of large rat tail comb, I've just made like a side parting in my hair, and what we're going to do is because if you've got shorter hair, you don't want to take too much hair from the front. So I've kind of made a small parting in my hair, and basically what we're going to do is just take two sections of hair from the side. So I've taken a small section here, as you can see, and I'm just going to twist it and just pin it if I can, just to hold it. Just a small section, and then this side I'm going to take a kind of bigger section of hair, not too big because we want to make the kind of beehive thing. I think that I've got both in my hair. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is just kind of twist this up and just kind of pin it out the way, because we'll work with this afterwards. Okay, so now this doesn't have to be like really neat or anything, but what we're going to do is we're just going to, I'm just using my fingers really, taking a section of hair to make our beehive. Now obviously because my hair's shorter, it's a little bit more difficult to work with to get this look. So I'm just taking it roughly because I don't think it really has to look really neat. But I think with this bit, I don't really want it to kind of stick out. So we're going to put some product in just to hold it down so it's a little less kind of coming out a bit more. So you see we've got our kind of hair we're going to use for the kind of beehive. So I'm just going to take this bit and just tie it in a band. So obviously if you have longer hair, this style will be a lot more easier to work with. Now I'm going to put some product in actually. So just get your moisturizer, styler, just rub a little bit, and I'm just going to rub it over my hair so I get it to stay. And all I'm going to do is just kind of tuck the hair under. So all it is I'm just doing this, and then I'm tucking the hair behind and pushing it. So I'll show you from the front. So that's from the front, and then from the back I'm just tucking the ends under like that, and then it comes out looking a little bit like that. So what I'm going to do is just use the bobby pin and secure it down. Now this is the hard bit because you don't want it to move, so I just put one on one side. We can fix it after, but as long as you secure the ends, first of all, that's the main bit. So I just secured that down. Now we kind of start to use more bobby pins to work with the hair. So, okay, so now what I'm going to do is use the wavy bobby pins to just kind of create this shape, and so it stays in place, because obviously it's moving around a lot. So So it's a little bit like moulding the hair. That's what I would really kind of say this is like. It's like moulding the hair around your, like using your hands to kind of create a shape. If you want to put hairspray in it, you can, but I don't feel I need to. Okay, so I've got my kind of beehive thing going on now. And you can just see how you basically use my hands, use wavy bobby pins to mold the shape. I don't know how it looks on the back. Okay, looks fine from the back, I suppose. So we've got our shape from the front. So now, what I'm going to do is just going to put a little bit more moisturizer in my hair. Because I just want this to kind of lie a little bit flat because it's kind of puffing out. So, I just want that to kind of lie a little bit flat and less kind of puffy. Now what we're going to do is take out the front parts of the hair that were held by the clips. And again, some product in just to... This is kind of like creating the fringe part of the hair. So I'm just going to... make this side a little bit more slick and just kind of get the bobby pin and pin it behind my ear so it's like this. Now you could either just leave this part of the hair out to complete the look, or you can get another bobby pin and just pin the hair back round behind the ear. So it's up to you what you want to do. If you don't like hair on your face, then you can just kind of leave it like this. So as long as you have enough bobby pins in your hair to kind of make sure the beehive thingy doesn't move, you're good to go. Kind of like it with the hair out. So from the back and back round.